Before taking our work to the print shop, we need to export it to a universal image file and set up a few options. To get to the export dialog, click File in the menu bar, then Export. Here we first need to type in a file name and select a destination. In the Format menu, we can see that Swift Publisher can export to PDF, TIFF, JPEG, PNG, and EPS. Let's choose PDF since it's the most widely used format, and check out the available options. The first option is Bleeds. Note that we always need to check with our print shop before setting them up, as requirements may differ from place to place. We can also opt to include cut marks based on what we have set up for our bleeds. The Image Quality drop-down menu allows us to select a DPI, or dots per inch. Usually 300 DPI is plenty for printing at home, but there may be situations when you need a higher or lower DPI. In the next drop-down list, we have a choice of quartz filters, which basically apply some graphic effect to all images in the PDF. You may find useful the Reduce File Size filter. As long as we want to have original images, we select None. The Convert Text to Curves option basically makes sure that your font displays correctly on other computers. It's a good idea to use this when your document contains fonts not installed on your system by default. Let's keep that checked. The Format as Booklet option is useful for catalogs and booklets. If enabled, the program will position the document's pages two up on a sheet, arranging the pages in the proper order. That is, when the exported PDF is printed and folded, you get a small, neat booklet. If necessary, we can also choose a PDF workflow. And what that does is optimize our PDF for various situations. For example, if we need to send it by email, then the file needs to be compressed. Let's leave that at None. Click OK and save our PDF. And voila! We've got our exported document ready to be sent to the print shop.